Well, you guys were convincing. Hi, nice to meet you. I'll give you my real name. My name's Susan, and nice to meet you guys. So I'm here. A little bit about myself. I'm odd. I talk about myself because I'm confused as who I am as a person, and hopefully before I reach, you know, a death, that I figure out that I have some sort of qualification to be a human being. So, hi, nice to meet you. I guess someone told me, well, a couple people told me that I was funny and I should make a YouTube video. And this was, you know, started a long time ago with people like, hey, you know, you can do it. And then I was just like, You see this? You see this? Yeah. So, here I am. I like flamingos. Well, let me start off. I have a weird story about flamingos. This is one point about my life. I'm a very sarcastic individual, and I'll make jokes because I think it's funny. Like, I spend my days thinking of clever things to say, and I only make myself laugh. I'll be like, like, people will be like, why are you laughing? And I'm just like, you wouldn't get it. Just be like, people just get too offended. But I also don't explain my jokes to people, and then it's kind of like an awkward moment. But my flamingo. So here I am. I'm at the wee age of, say, 14, 13, and my grandmother used to take me to go see open houses. And I've grown to appreciate architecture because of that. I love looking at houses. I'm just like, arcanasms. It's like orgasm, looks for architecture, arcanasms. Arcanasms. And so there's this house, this one particular house that had pink flamingo mailbox. It was a mailbox, and it was like shaped like flamingo. These you guys can't see very well, but these are little flamingo lights. And I hope they probably look more like turkeys. But flamingo lights, I'll get there. So I tell my grandma, you know, I want flamingo. I want flamingo. I want the plastic flamingo suit. Because to me, I always thought they were a little tacky, but at the same time, and now I've grown to appreciate the pink flamingo because of its majestic and prestigious value in this society. So I made this joke and I was like, I want flamingos, you know, like I want to have flamingos all up in this house, you know. Next thing you know, I get these flamingo beautiful lights. I have flamingo rave lights. They like light up in LED colors. They go for it. If I can dig them out somehow and figure out how to plug them into something, then eventually you'll see them. I also have like a metal statue of flamingo. I have flamingo currants. I have flamingo shampoo. Okay, I'm not like, I like cats. I love my cats. Give me a cat any time of day. I'll be your cat lady. I'll be your cat lady. But flamingos was a joke. And now I have all this flamingo shit. What could one do but just be like, I have flamingos. There's no point to that story. I guess that's what it is. Most of my stories have no points in that, so I guess people don't listen to me. God, this is a sad realization happening here. But I don't particularly have flamingos by choice. It's not like I went out of my way in time to go out and buy a flamingo light set. Rita. So for all y'all who knew me in high school, and for all y'all that went to the shed, if you guys know what shed I'm talking about, Rita was a class act lady. She was a 3 foot tall flamingo. Yay, hi, I'm sitting down. Yay, hi. Light up flamingo that one leg. Eventually broke down and just went there. We had a little ribbon on her. Next thing you know, bada bing, bada boom, a couple years later. No. All great stars die. Makes me sad. I recently found like a receipt from the box that Rita came in, and I'm hoping through my time and investing, you know, some research, possibly finding a new Rita and call her, I don't know, Rowena. Go keeping with the eyes. So that's point one. A little strange, fun story fact with you. Relationships. I don't do them. I don't do them. I have my reasons. I mean, like, I mean, let's not go all Lifetime story on this shit. But, I mean, like, I understand. It'd be nice to be, like, you know, but at the same time, I'm just like, no. I mean, like, I have, like, I feel suffocated for my dog, you know, and I love my dog. I love cats, too, right? But complicated. But this pup, right, is the sweetest, most kindest thing. It will look at me when she's awake with the softest and most gentlest eyes. And it just sleeps like a person with spoons. It's no homo, man, but I love it. But sometimes I'm just like, you know, dog, I can't always pet you. Dog, you know, like dog, man, you know? Too much for me. Instead, I'll be just like, I banged someone last night. And, yeah, that's that. That was a 2 for 3. Where to go? Okay, my sarcasm. I don't even know it's sarcasm because it's just me being an asshole. What I think. I mean, I guess people think I'm nice, and it's just because I'm quiet and I don't really speak my mind. But then again, I don't really. I just think of clever things to say. Once again, I just think about clever things to say all day, and I'm the only one laughing. And that kind of sucks because that means, you know, people get offended. And I don't grow armpit hair, by the way. Don't grow it. And true story, legit. I got my tongue pierced recently. I love it. I recently changed it to a smaller bar, so now it's not so much in my mouth, but it's on my tongue. Makes me really happy. It's not because I'm a lesbian. It's not because, you know, like, I'm a cool rebel. It's because I like red Converse. Now, my red Converse story, I'm going to tell you. So, I met this guy, and I really liked him, but I didn't really like him. The thing is, I don't know this person. How am I supposed to know, like, you know, like, when he was 12, he, you know, got chased down by the bear and the mountain and this, that, the other. You know, I don't know the life story, so I don't get too like, my love, oh my god, where you been all my life? Ooh. Instead, I was just like, if I could just talk to him and just be like, hi, you know, like, you're really hot. You know, I'd really, really like to bang you. And maybe get schnockered up a couple times, you know, and have a friend time. Eventually, my Converse did the deal. Compliment me a Converse, and I was just like, hey, you know, got me a little confidence, and was like, yeah, I'll talk to you. Next thing you know, class goes in, and it was a dance class, and next thing you know, I'm fucking him, and he has a big dick, and I was like, I can't usually take it, and I was just like, he laid me down like the golden goddess I was. But I don't know what happened, but he was just talking, and he was just like, he must really care about fashion, and was like, you wear Converse. And I'm just like, because I wear Converse, I care about fashion. And that puts me onto my next topic. Clothing. I love clothing, but I just don't dress right for my generation. I don't know what I dress like. I'm just like, I'll be in my room, which is right here, and I'll just put something on and be like, it's gonna work. And then I go out and then I see these people and they're just like gorgeous, and I'm just like, just stay home. Yes. I hope I can get some laughs and kicks. This is my first video. I'm not really sure what you guys want to hear about, what you guys want to know, to whoever's watching. But leave little comments, leave a little post, send me little messages. Don't be afraid of me, because I'm more scared of you than you are of me. It's my own Josephine Walker. You don't know me, but I know you. Josephine Walker. So, many of you guys who may be seeing this, I've given you a fake name. And it's not a fake name. It's my name. Lucrecia, Rowena, Anna, Joanne, Stacy, Holly, What's the other one? I have a couple more. But the reasons these are characters I make up to protect myself from myself. That doesn't sound right. These are the names and characters I give myself to give me confidence. To be like, hey, Stacy's got it. Hey, the Kretz. You know, like, I have to. So that way I just don't, like, spaz out on y'all. Because I could just be, you could just have me talking like this at a party the entire time. And I probably do now. I probably just, like, chat your ear off, and then you're just like, really, 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 who invited this thing? And then you see me. I'm going. Yeah. So I don't talk a lot when I first meet people, and then they kind of get the feel of me, and then I get the feel. I guess it's normal for most people. So I'm just a little too hard on myself. I'm a big water drinker. My life shuts down if I don't have water. Yeah, I smoke cigarettes. I love them. Love them even fucking. But water is a whole different story. I need water to live. And that's one of the times I really become a bitch, and I don't have water, and I was like, what am I gonna do? I'm gonna get dehydrated. I'm gonna die. I can't have water. I can't do this. And next thing you know, wow. Yeah, I bought Pimpin' Planet. So, this should be fair enough. A fair little snippet. If you guys really want to get to know me and really want to hear some weird stories on how I get myself in these weird situations, because, you know, I'll just be up to you and just be like, hey, I was in a commercial, or hey, I just was, like, in Crenshaw for some odd reason, but I don't really want to discuss it. Because, you know, you probably don't really care right now. But if you really want to know some crazy stories, don't be like, what's the craziest thing you've ever done? Because, like, nigga, I live. I know, it's so pretentious of me. That's so pretentious of me. But think about it. Think about it if someone asks that of you. Be specific. Like, be like, hey, is your room green? Legere. It is. Thank you, and this is me signing off. Captain.